Pacific Coliseum as Mike Richter gets set to go after win number 16. He is 15-6 in the playoffs. That's a tough night.
Well, the Canucks publicly said he doesn't do a good job playing his angles because they got a few pucks by him. I think they're dead wrong. I think he's a great angles goaltender, and I think he'll show his worth right here in Vancouver.
Kirk McLean came up with his 14th win in Game 5.
I think what's interesting there is McLean's had 5 breakaways in the series against him. He stopped 4 of them where the Rangers have shot the puck on the breakaway. He's only allowed 1 breakaway goal, and that was Kovalov when he was deked on the play. Interesting little stat.
Bill McCreary, his 12th playoff game. He did game number 2 of this series in New York. The Rangers are 3-1 in games he's officiated in the playoffs. Vancouver 2-1.
This morning, Bill McCreary met with the supervisor of officials, Brian Lewis. They talked a lot about watching behind the play if the players are getting together. Try to keep the players in the game. And they did, as you said, watch game number 5, so he knows what these two teams are all about.
You saw the numbers. Rangers 7-2 on the road in the playoffs with 2 wins in this series. Canucks 6-5 at home, 0-2 in this series. Leach with the puck.
And the Rangers have thrown the first 2 checks already, Sam, taking the body.
And Toski takes the body and knocks down Bukaboom. Graves to Messier. Messier, Graves, and Anderson with Leach and Bukaboom. McIntyre with Hunter and Antoski. Brown and Hedekin for Vancouver. Antoski hit by Bukaboom. Hunter hit by Messier. The puck is loose. Messier doesn't know where it is. Then he got hit by Antoski trying to get loose. Leach moves the puck to Graves.
Mark Messier,
early.
Mark Messier has shown up in ill humor. He is mean on his first shift here.
He dumps in. He goes against Hedekin with the stick. Brown left the puck behind him. Off the stick to Messier. Couldn't tee it up. Brown against Graves in the corner. Up the boards. Poked to Zuboff. He kept it in. Taken back by Hedekin. And able to dump it out of the zone. Zuboff and Lowe have come on with Larber, Matteau, and Tikkanen. Lead for Matteau off his skate. Played by Gerald Dinnick. Out of the zone, Zuboff has it. Matteau chased by Dinnick, sends it into the Vancouver zone. Dinnick chased Matteau all the way across to the boards and hit him against the boards.
Mike Keenan was in Vancouver for an interview to be the head coach of the Vancouver Canucks. Vancouver hired a guy by the name of Bill LaForge, and Mike went on to Philadelphia.
Taking a nice move off the boards to Nemchinov. Right now it's Nemchinov with Tikkanen and Noonan on the ice for the Rangers. Tikkanen tried to get a shot off. Went into the corner. Dinnick checks Noonan. Nemchinov tried to take it away from McLean. Craven after the puck. Blocked by Noonan and Tikkanen. Craven digging for it with a stick.
The Rangers 2 forwards deep like that. Nemchinov has to stay high.
Out comes Murray Craven. He's on with Adams and Bure. It's intercepted nicely by Zuboff. Gave it away to Bure. Bure upends Tikkanen, then got knocked down by Lowe. And that shot was steered aside by McLean, played by David Babich.
Very, very intense beginning for these two teams. Bill McCreary letting them play as a referee. The sticks are down, but it's mean.
Leach for the puck, overskated, and he is knocked down by Bure. A flying check by Bure. He may have left his feet on the check.
See, that's the thing about Bure, Sam. You can hit him, and he'll hit you back. He'll take the hits, and he'll give the hits.
Bukaboom plays it off the boards.
Brian Leach appears to be okay. He was hit hard. Remember, these boards of glass don't move whatsoever, but he's fine. He stayed on the ice.
Rangers have McTavish on. This is Cliff Ronning. Saved by Richter. It trickles wide of the net. Ronning with Bomesso and Jelena for Vancouver. Big hit by Bukaboom. Knocked down Ronning. A hit by McTavish. He bounces off Bomesso. In deep is Brian Glynn. Bukaboom after him. He got a piece of Larmer as well. Bomesso. He's double-teamed by Bukaboom and McTavish. What hitting we're seeing. Leach. He gets hit. Jelena centers. Intercepted by Larmer
and
with
Bomesso
penalty. All along. Penalty upcoming.
And they did not hear the whistle as Lume shot the puck wide after the penalty is being handed out. The Rangers, I believe, will take the first penalty. Leach has been nailed twice, and we're just over 3 minutes in. Pavel Bure moves in on Leach. He's not held up. Boom. Remember we said that the Rangers have to hold up the forwards for Vancouver to save Zuboff and to save Leach. Well, it didn't happen there. And then seconds later, Bukaboom took the elbowing call as he elbowed Bomesso.
Brown after the puck. Bure is at the point. Linden, Ronning, and Courtnall up front. Bure is playing the right point. Knocked down by Lidster. Tries to clear it, was blocked. Lidstrom looking for the puck. It comes back to Brown. Graves is there along with Messier. He's on Bore now. Down the boards for Courtnall. Leads quickly to him. Ronning picked up by Lidstrom. Rangers quick for the man with the puck. Now Courtnall's got it. Moving toward the net. Save Richter. Ronning back to Bore. His shot is wide of the net. Brown moves it around to Ronning. Ronning puts it in front. Missed by Courtnall. Shot by Linden. Stick save by Richter. Rebound loose. Richter tries to recover. It went behind the net. Ronning's got the puck. Chased by Leach. Taken away by Graves. Kept it at the line by Courtnall. Courtnall moves down. Good pressure by the Canucks. Courtnall looking toward the net. Fakes the shot on Messier, who takes it away and clears.
Rangers need a change. And don't worry about Mike Richter. He has been splendid to start the game. Three Vancouver shots. Every one of them have been good ones.
Canucks are 1-for-31 on the power play in the series, and that goal by Trevor Linden in game four.
See, when Vancouver sets up, they're a pretty good power play team, but they've had trouble right here getting out of the zone to be able to set up. Now, Bure's been out there now a minute and a half. See, this is where they're having trouble, Sam, right here.
Almost took it away. It's out of the zone, and Zubov has it.
The Rangers good with their penalty kill when Vancouver tries to generate their team to move up ice.
No score in the game. 4:40 gone by in the first. 22 seconds to go in Pukaboom's penalty. Lume with the puck. Lume across the line and shoots. Save. Richter reaches for the rebound. Low moved it aside. Kept in by Momesso. Blocked by Nemchinov. Momesso has it. Pass to Craven. Now save off of Adams. Great save by Richter. Nemchinov has trouble with Adams and Craven. Zubov looks up ice. Gets it to Anderson. Power play is over. Anderson moves down. Anderson with Bukaboom. Anderson pass across, intercepted by Craven. The open man was Jay Wells. Zubov to the puck.
Penalty
on him.
Penalty killer's got it done, but it was Mike Richter who was the key penalty killer.
Matteau finds the puck and sends it in. 14:35 to go in the first. No score in the game. Moved up the boards and out of the zone. Rangers have to go back to get it. Antoski bearing down on Richter, swings it around to Doug Lidstrom. Lidstrom gets help from Larmer. Moves it out of the zone. Taken back by Gerald Dittock. Canucks had four shots on goal on the power play. Off the end boards to John McIntyre. Bounces down. Wells with a hit on Hunter, allowing Lidstrom to take the puck. Lidstrom waits. Gets across the line. Tikkanen goes in deep. Around the boards to Tikkanen. Tikkanen checked by Antoski. Wrapped up by Antoski. Puck kept in by Larmer to Matteau. Now to Tikkanen. Larmer cuts in. The pass blocked by Antoski. Hunter tries to move it. Bounces down to Leach. He avoids Hunter. He waits. Moved it ahead into the circle. Clearing attempt blocked. Tikkanen has it. His pass blocked by Glenn. It's sent all the way down by Antoski for an icing by the Canucks.
See, the Rangers wanted to work Antoski, McIntyre, and Hunter. A slower forward line, and they appeared as though they were going to, and then finally Hunter smartly iced the puck. Ryan Leach has been hit hard twice already in this game.
Mike Richter, who said he'd love to have another shot at that shot by Dave Babich. He says, if I do, I'll get it next time. But he started off well in this game. 13:39 to go in the first period. No score in the game. Messier, Graves, and Kovalov on now for the Rangers. Messier bumped in the corner. Kovalov has the puck along the board. Brett Hedekin on him. Messier kicks it up the boards. Kovalov wrestles with Hedekin down on the ice. Messier's got the puck. Now to Graves for the shot. Stick save by McClain. Bukaboom pinches in. Takes a hit from Courtnall. Hedekin overskates the puck. He's hit by Messier. Graves comes into the corner. Takes the puck. Out to Bukaboom. Bukaboom down the boards. Graves tied up in the corner by Linden. Brown moves it out to Courtnall. Courtnall winds up and drives it into the corner. Bounces to Richter. Sends it right back into the corner. Courtnall had 8 shots on goal in game 5 after having 10 shots the first 4 games. Graves moves up ice with Hedekin all over him. Hedekin takes it away nicely. A little over 7 minutes gone by, first period. No score in the game. Poked ahead by Lowe. Took a hit from Linden. Hedekin has the puck with Nemchinov forechecking. Nemchinov with Noonan and Anderson now on for the Rangers. Lowe to Zubov. Craven forechecking for Vancouver. Anderson pass across. Bure didn't see it. He's hit by Noonan, allowing Nemchinov to move in. Nemchinov fires. Save McClain. Puts it into the corner for Murray Craven. Craven slowed down by Nemchinov. Courtnall with the puck. Courtnall across the line. Blocked by Zubov. Kept in by Lume to Courtnall. Pass to Craven. He missed the shot. Bure's got the puck. Bure shoots and he hit his own man, Lume. Courtnall gets it back to Jurki Lume. Lume checked by Noonan, dumps it deep. Puck to Zuboff behind the Rangers' net. 12 minutes to go in the first with no score. Anderson, quick pass to Larmer. Larmer across, takes the shot wide, bounces out. Knocked away from Larmer by Lume. Zuboff centers. Anderson regains control. Plays it behind the net for Larmer. Chases down against Lume. Tikkanen in the corner, turns to make a pass. Craven checks him. Tikkanen trying to keep it alive along the boards.
Rangers have only had one shot on goal so far. Vancouver's been solid in their own zone.
Here's Matteau moving against Lume, who lost his stick. One-handed pass intercepted by Adams, and he clears the zone.
Rangers driving to the net, trying to make something happen, maybe even draw a penalty, but so far Vancouver has been very good in their own zone.
Cliff Ronning sends it back to Hedekin.
Let me apologize. Make that three shots on goal, not one for the Rangers.
Zuboff looks up ice. Ronning, Mamesso, and Jelena on for Vancouver. Tikkanen with the puck. Nobody there as he played it down the boards. Ronning goes back for it. Messier and Graves are on. Alexei Kovalov has come back on. This is Jelena moving in. Lined up by Bukaboom for the hit. Mamesso slashing at Leach once again. Kovalov has the puck. Able to dump it clear. 10:45 to go in the first. Brown goes back for it. Icing whistled on the Rangers.
Graves tries to hold him up, but he still gets through. Two slashes and a hit on Brian Leach. Mometso loves to hit. He loves to go after Leach, and he's going to continue to do it. The Rangers have got to hold him up.
Ronning won the draw. Brown toward the net. Knocked aside by Richter. Bukaboom against Jelena. Mometso against Leach. Mometso gave it away to Bukaboom off the boards. Swung around by Mometso. In comes Jeff Brown. Toward the net, through the screen of Bukaboom. Another shot wide, the rebound saved by Richter. Mike Richter robs Cliff Ronning with an unbelievable save.
And another penalty to the Rangers. And it's the line of Ronning, Jelena, and Mometso who have drawn both penalties. Mometso drew the penalty when he was elbowed by Jeff Bukaboom. Oh my, there's the holding by Brian Leach. That's the penalty. And then watch Richter react here. Oh my. What a save by Mike Richter. See how he's not out too far? Now he can move across, and Ronning did everything right. Got the puck in the air, got it on the net as he was going in the opposite direction, and Mike Richter reached up with great focus and grabbed the puck to hang on to it.
And it was Cliff Ronning who openly criticized Mike Richter's goaltending, said Mike Richter plays his angles poorly. He's out too far and leaves an empty net when there's a rebound.
A little psychological warfare, and it's also easy to do that after you win, but you can give Ronning credit in this fact. Ronning has been one of the best three forwards on the ice in almost every game for both teams. Not just Vancouver, for both teams. And his line's getting it done here.
Leach for interference at 9:39. Canucks' second power play. They're 0 for 1. They had four shots on goal on the first one.
And once again, Vancouver goes with Bure on the point.
Linden won the draw. The shot scored. Deflected on the way in. Canucks take the lead. Tikkanen took the faceoff. Canucks won it and wind up with the goal.
Vancouver's had the better forecheck. Vancouver's winning faceoffs. Vancouver's drawing penalties. And they're forcing Mike Richter to be superhuman. Well, there's a shot that finally beats him. The Rangers have been outshot 9-3. Vancouver's on a roll. And you can see how Zuboff couldn't hold his man from getting to the front of the net. There's a screen. There's the deflection way up high. The puck goes right over the shoulder of Richter, and the Canucks are on fire. They're playing well. They deserve the lead, and the Rangers have to find a way to get their game back.
Canucks' second power play goal of the series, and they take a 1-0 lead. Bukaboom, unable to clear, was Koser. Now he forces his way out of the zone. McTavish, Koser, and Gilbert on for the Rangers. Antoski with a hit on Koser. Koser battling Babich for it. Back into the Rangers zone.
See, Vancouver's not carrying the puck in very often either. They're dumping it in, and they are charging, and they are hoping to punish.
Fired in by McTavish. 9:45 to go in the first. 1-0, Vancouver leading it. Cleared out by Babich. Brown gets credit for the goal, assisted by Linden. Must have hit a Ranger on the way in. Leach's shot stopped. McTavish's shot is stopped.
You'll see Tikkanen move out after losing the draw. The
puck will go off of him, and there's the man driving to the net, and Zuboff doesn't pick him up. See, Tikkanen moving out. The puck will hit him. Now look towards the goal net. There's half the screen provided as the Canucks did everything right, winning the draw and scoring the power play goal.
Fourth consecutive game, the Canucks have scored the first goal of the game. Kevin Lowe with the puck moving down, looking toward the net. Pass blocked by Hedekin. The goal, Jeff Brown, his fifth of the playoffs, second of the series from Trevor Linden at 9:42. 3 seconds after the penalty was assessed to Brian Leetch. 3 seconds into the power play.
See, I don't think that concerns the Rangers, Sam, giving up the first goal. But what concerns me with the Rangers is they're not showing any confidence yet.
Tikkanen, pass across, block, deflects on goal, and it's gobbled up by McLean with a glove. So the Larner gets into a little pushing and shoving, as does Matteau.
I think that the Rangers have not shown the skating legs that Vancouver has shown so far. And you came up with a good point this morning. We talked about Vancouver coming back after game two from New York, getting in at 7 o'clock in the morning, body time, which was New York time. They then went to their homes where their kids are there, the phone rings, the wives want this, it goes on and on. This time, they did the same thing. They flew all the way back to Vancouver, only they checked into a hotel after, right, as opposed to going home, and you don't have the outside distractions. And that makes a major difference regarding how loggy your body can be. In Vancouver, headed by Pat Quinn, have really looked strong as we start the game. The Rangers have had 5 shots, not many good ones. The Vancouver have had 10 shots, mostly good ones.
Messier wins from Linden. Bukubon lines up and shoots just wide as McLean was screened. Leetch pinches in, it's knocked out by Lafayette, and he was tripped up by Leetch. Messier back for the puck. Little screen from Bukubon. Messier avoids Linden. Slides it ahead to Kovalov. Kovalov comes in and shoots. It's blocked by Brown. Kovalov again toward the net. Deflected. Bounces into the corner. Graves against Lafayette. Graves went down. Courtnall is there. Lafayette got knocked down. Graves up with the puck. Now Kovalov down to Messier. Couldn't get a shot off. Out of the zone. Leetch recovers. 8.5 minutes to go in the first. Vancouver leading 1-0. Bounces past McLean. Lume has it. Graves forechecking. Up the middle of Jeff Courtnall. Off the skate of Nemchinov, but across to Trevor Linden, who shoots off the glove, saved by Richter, bounces off the glass.
Linden had to go high with Kevin Lowe sliding down, and I think Richter read that and made a fine save.
Zuboff coming forward, Zuboff against Babich, puts it all the way through. Down for the puck comes Anderson, chips it up into the crowd, deflected off the stick of Martin Gelinas. 8:01 to go, first period. Rangers trailing 1-0. And have been outshot 11-5 thus far.
Talked about Richter reading plays. Mike Richter, I think, read that Linden had the puck. You see him here. Now look at Kevin Lowe come across. Watch him go down. Immediately, Richter has to read high. And that was a terrific save. The top corner was there. Look at Lowe's going down. Goalie's got to think high. Get the hand out and bang. Beautiful save by Mike Richter, knocking the puck high up over top of the net.
Richter showing confidence. It's not typical of the Rangers' defensive style. They gave up 37 shots on goal in Game 5. That's the most they've given up in regulation time in any game of the playoffs. And they've given up 11 already in this first period. Richter covers up on the bouncer.
Well, they've been smart dump-ins by Vancouver. And the big line's on the ice again, or I term it the big line for Vancouver. No Bure on it. There's no Linden on it. There's no Adams on it. But there's little Cliff Ronning, who's playing as a little man, a big man's game, and he has helped his wingers get scoring chances, and he has helped his wingers draw penalties.
Tied for the team lead in points in this series with 6.
Every single game in the series, win or lose, Ronning has played very, very well.
3 full years with the Canucks after coming back from Italy and being traded over from St. Louis to Vancouver.
Now Vancouver comes back with Craven as the center iceman for Bure. I don't think it matters who the center iceman is for Bure. He does things on his own. He doesn't need a centerman to get him the puck. He gets it, and he's a great, great skater through the neutral zone with speed. Rangers' Messier line, Sam, had a good shift to try and slow Vancouver down.
But the fact that Craven's a left-handed shot offside is whistled against Vancouver. The fact that Craven's a left-handed shot and a good passer seems to help.
But Bure is a right winger, right?
Yeah.
But he ends up on the left side of the ice more. He's all over the place. He's a tough guy to try and slow down. What Craven has been doing, though, prior to this game, has been on the ice a lot against Mark Messier. However, in this game, they've kept him away from Messier. We've seen Tikkanen opposite Bure if the Rangers get the last change, which they have just now. Vancouver leaves their forwards on the ice. And you're seeing this matchup. That's the one player Mike Keenan is aware of for Vancouver. It's Pavel Bure. They want to deny him the puck.
Yakhchinov has had two straight wins from Craven on faceoffs. Leach takes the pass. He's met by Adams and forced back. Leach waits. Forechecking now is Craven. Off the boards to Bukaboom. He missed it. Bure takes it and moves in. Bure shoots. Save, Rick. The rebound kicked away. Leach has the puck. Pressed by Adams. Bukaboom has it again. This time gets it to Noonan out of the zone. 14 shots on goal by the Canucks. And Mike Richter has stopped 13 to keep his team in the game. Just under 7 minutes to go in the first period. Canucks leading 1-0. Lume with a quick pass. Tipped across by Leach. Nemchinov gets to it. Off the boards, give away to Brian Glynn, who gives it right back to Bukaboom.
Vancouver's denying the Rangers the first pass, and if they make the first pass, they're not getting a second pass. Therefore, there's no offensive flow whatsoever.
Linden avoids Kovalov, moves in, pass to Lafayette. Lafayette missed it. Linden shoots, saved by Richter. Zubov's got it. Richter looked behind him, but he had stopped it. Hedekin has the puck. 6:20 to go in the first period. Courtnall to Hedekin, missed it. Low, able to clear the zone, took a hit from Lafayette. Canucks finishing every check they can.
Zubov
has the puck.
See if they make one or two passes here.
Zubov to Kovalov. Nice pass to Larmer. He's in against Hedekin. Left it behind. Shoots. Deflected off of Hedekin. Zubov couldn't play it. Courtnall brings it out. Took a bump from Larmer. Kevin Lowe waits. His pass deflected off of Lafayette to Courtnall. Courtnall gave it up to Zubov. Kovalov turns. Kovalov on Hedekin. Kovalov moves in. Around the net. Took a bump. Still has the puck. Kovalov. Lost control, it's behind him, and it's cleared out by Brett Hedekin. 5:35 to go in the first. Doug Lidster. In comes Jay Wells, left it for Messier. Messier picked up by Ronning. Centers off the stick of McLean. Good play as Zubov was, rather Anderson was cutting in toward the net. Messier back to Lidster for the shot. Save McLean, he's got it with Graves there. Graves wrestled down by Diddick.
No rebound, McLean held on to the puck. The shot was a little high, because Lidster had to rush the shot and went right into the midsection of the goaltender, and that's an easy puck to stop. The Rangers, though, with Messier's line, the last two shifts, Sam, they're starting to get something going in the other team's zone. But it's the only line that's doing it. No one else is. The other players on this club have got to get it going a little bit. Adam Graves has talked about his legs coming back. You'll see, again, a quick shot. Real quick shot. Right here. Trevor Linden through the screen, who's there, but Mike Richter again. 15 shots he's had, and nearly every one's been a tough one.
Messier wins to Lidster. Rich shot goes wide. Anderson looking for it. Messier gets to it. Trying to ward off running. One-hand pass. Shot by Gilbert. Deflects to the corner. 5:05 to go in the first. Vancouver leading 1-0. Mamesso tries to clear it. Blocked by Lidster. Lidster moves in. Shot off. Deflects into the corner. Ronning takes it off the boards.
Well, Messier's having a war, man. He is playing hard.
Jelena across the line against Gilbert. Around Gilbert. Pass in front. Off the skate. Saved by Richter. Went off the skate of Jay Wells. And Richter had to make a save. Outlet pass to Anderson. Now to Messier. Messier across against Glynn. Tipped it away. Anderson's got it. He lost it to Lume. Outlet to Adams. Adams slowed down by Leach. Puck picked up by Jelena. Jelena drops it off for Adams. He's picked up by Bukaboom. Lume in deep. Leach chases him and bumps him against the boards.
Messier's been out there a long time now with Anderson.
Jelena checked by Bukaboom. 4:20 to go in the first. Vancouver leading 1-0. Anderson finds the puck. He's stopped by Adams. Rangers need a stoppage here. Jelena moves it out to Brian Glynn. He shoots. Blocked in front. Craven finds the puck. Shot it wide. Around the boards. Tikkanen gets there with room. Dumps it out of the zone. Glynn plays it back to Lume as the Rangers change. Tikkanen, Noonan, and Nemchinov are on. Glynn brings it across. 3:50 to go in the first. 1-0 Vancouver. Giveaway to Bure. His shot goes wide into the corner and up the boards. Out of the zone. Noonan trying to get by Brown. Tikkanen does. Leaves it for Noonan. Takes the shot wide. Around the boards and out of the zone the other way. Kevin Lowe has it. Now Sergei Zubov. Zubov avoids Bure, then gave up the puck. Hedekin for Bure. Two-line pass. Whistled against the Canucks. Stops play with 3:28 to go.
Mark Messier's line has been the best line for the Rangers. Watch, easy. Hits Babich. Babich will come back at him. Boom. Now watch Messier get up and go back at Babich. Nearly every shift Messier looks to see where the referee is. Watch the two-hander to the ankle there. Every shift Messier's been on the ice, he has played hard, he has played physical, and has had the only, he's been on the only line for the Rangers that have worked the puck deep.
Kovalov is back centering Larmer and Matteau. Larmer played it ahead, goes up into the crowd. Peter Nedved, one-time Vancouver Canuck, in attendance tonight. Puck out of the zone.
That's quite a story, especially with Kovalov on the ice.
Yeah.
Nedved has not been a good playoff performer yet in his young career. Graves now is opposite Bure.
Kovalov finds the puck again. Didn't get a shot off. Backhands it ahead behind Graves. Graves against Linden. Set up to Zubov. Zubov checked by Courtnall. Knocked away by Linden. Sends it out to Bure. Lowe trying to get back. Bure and Brown. Bure shoots high.
Rangers have got to go to the net with a puck. They're being way too fancy in the Vancouver zone. Go to the net with a puck.
Kovalov hit Bure. Linden hit Zubov. Larmer slides it out of the zone. 2:40 to go in the first. Bure hits Kovalov back. Graves moves in against Gerald Dittick. Centers almost tipped by Larmer. Went off his stick but wide of the net. Linden against Larmer along the boards. Larmer swings it in. McLean leaves it for Dittick. Hedekin comes out with it. A bouncer blocked by Richter. Tough bouncer. Joey Koser comes out with it. On with McTavish and Gilbert. Koser moves in. Koser shoots tip by Dittick around the boards. Jelena picks it up. One hands it ahead to Cliff Ronning. Ronning against Leach. Sweeps it aside. Rides Ronning down. Bukaboo moves it out. Fans upset that Ronning was ridden down hard by Leach, who stayed on him. Richter stops the puck with a minute 55 to go in the first period. Up the boards to Gilbert. Able to clear the zone. Lume hit by McTavish. Leach looking for the puck. So is Gilbert. And the whistle stopped play in front of the Rangers bench with a minute 46 to go in this first period. The Canucks out shooting the Rangers 16-6, but and lead only 1-0 on the power play goal.
The score flatters the New York Rangers because of Mike Richter. Pavel Bure with Kovalov as they battle, as they both meet the puck. There's Bure on the off wing. He's a right winger. There he is over on the left side of the ice.
Well, I think he did that because Kovalov had hit him first and he wanted to get him back. Following the first period, Al Troutwig has joined us, coming in from Houston after the Knicks win last night. He'll talk with Kevin Lowe. JD and I will have first period highlights. We'll send you back to the MSG Sports Desk with Bob Page. So stay with us. And we hope you're enjoying the action at Madison Square Garden. Hope it's a great night there. Fans have packed the garden tonight.
I hope they enjoyed the Knicks win last night. Did they ever play well? And that was fun to watch.
Knicks play tomorrow night at the Garden. Game 3 against the Houston Rockets. Puck moved up the boards. Pinching in Jay Wells. Keeps it in the corner. Noonan reverses to Tiikkanen. Tiikkanen slides it right through the crease. Brown plays it off the boards. It's stopped by Wells, but he missed it. And Bure almost broke right past him. Now the outlet to Bure. Lidster is there. Pass to Craven. Craven against Tiikkanen. Drop pass to Adams, and he's run into by Wells. Good check. Nemchinov's got the puck with a minute 10 to go in the first period. Tiikkanen across the line. Trying to get it to Noonan, but it went off the skate. Noonan fires, stopped by McLean. Nemchinov around the net. Back pass. Away from Lidster, all the way back in the Rangers zone. 55 seconds to go.
I don't know if it's Vancouver's pressure or if the Rangers are uptight or what it is, but the passes have just not clicked for New York at all. That's why I think they should quit trying to be fancy and just go to the net with a puck.
Messier lost it on a poke check.
So there's another example. Another example of it right there. Graves was in shooting position. Put it on the net, you never know what happens.
35 seconds to go as Lowe circles back. Courtnall on him. Glenn Anderson plays it out of the zone where Brian Glynn takes it back. Off the corner boards, Kevin Lowe. Lafayette after him. Gets the stick in the midsection. Forces a turnover. Courtnall's pass comes back to Lume. His shot knocked down by Messier. Messier breaks out with a puck. Messier cuts it in the middle. And slides it to Zubov. Zubov moves in. Backhands it in front off the stick of McLean. Taken by Jeff Courtnall. Courtnall out with 5 seconds to go in the period. Courtnall against Leach. Knocked down by Graves. Leach pokes it out. Period comes to an end. The Rangers survive.
See, the Vancouver's best players had the shots. Bure had 2. Linden had 3.
Susan Sarandon wearing the Rangers jersey.
And into it. All right.
Tim Robbins.
This is a big movie city. A lot of American movies shot in Vancouver.
So I saw Tim on the elevator this afternoon. I asked him if he was in town to shoot a movie. He said, no, just visiting and here to see the game.
Ah, good for him. By the way, the scalpers were getting about $400 a ticket this morning. Slightly different. That's Canadian money too, Sam. That's about 35% less than American dollars. Not quite what we see in New York. Not quite.
But it is a sellout. 16,150 here at Pacific Coliseum. Hedekin with the puck behind his own net. Hedekin with Brown. McIntyre, Antoski, and Hunter for Vancouver. Bukaboom and Leach. Messier, Graves, and Kovalov for the Rangers. And the Go Canucks Go chant goes up. Kovalov with the puck. Long shot, saved by McLean. Hard shot by Kovalov. Out of the zone, McIntyre to the puck. Knocked away by Bukaboom. Pass across, taken by Messier.
Kovalov went to the net with a puck. Exactly what the Rangers have to do.
Messier dumps in. Brown takes and plays it off the boards and out. Bukaboom back for the puck. Off the boards, Leach couldn't play it. Murray Craven takes over and shoots. It's blocked. Deflects across. Adams against Messier. Craven in deep. Picked up by Bukaboom and blocks the pass. Didick gets to it. Took a hard hit from Graves. They both went down. Set up for Adams. A save by Richter. Another great save by Mike Richter. Kovalov's got the puck. Moving on Bure around him. Kovalov winds up. Shot it wide. Matteau in with a puck. Backhands it toward the net. Intercepted by Babich. Dave Babich out with a puck. Babich plays it off the boards. Babich says he tells Kirk McLean to always be alert when he's on the ice because three goals have gone in off his body in each of the last three games.
Steve Larmer, I think, has two of those.
Cleared out of the zone. Minute 40 gone by, second period. Zubov across to Kevin Lowe. Boy, didn't Kevin Lowe look exhausted at the end of the first period?
Well, he couldn't be interviewed. He was exhausted, so at least he took the time to get himself to recoup. Rangers have to be smart. If they're tired, their shifts have to be short and smart.
Matteau's pass was broken up in front. Bure wards off the stick check of Larmer, then circles back away from Tikkanen. Rangers changing. McTavish comes out. Bure slowed down momentarily. Long shot is high. Bounces off the glass. Wells plays quickly. Pass Gilbert. Good. Hard hit by Mameso. Knocked down McTavish. Gilbert moves
penalty
across. Gilbert's got the puck. Gilbert turns, he shoots, deflected over the top.
Penalty to Mameso. He forgot about the puck and took the body and he got penalized for it.
And the whistle stops play. The Rangers get their first power play of the game on the interference call against Sergio Mameso, who can't believe it.
He said, me? The puck went by. He never even bothered thinking about the puck and he went right into Craig McTavish, knocking him backwards. And he gets the penalty. The Rangers finally a power play.
Messier with Kovalov, or excuse me, with Larmer and Graves. The shot by Leach went wide. Zuboff at the other point. Out with it, Jeff Courtnell. Courtnell and Linden. Brown and Hedekin for Vancouver. Good play by Courtnell, controlling beautifully. Goes back pass, but gave it away to Graves. Graves dumps in. Rangers are 3-for-22 on the power play in this series. Kovalov with two of the goals, Zuboff the other one. Larmer hit from behind. Leach looking for the puck. Larmer can't control. Gave it up to Courtnell. Courtnell against Zuboff. Hedekin racing in. Pass to Hedekin. Tipped it wide. Graves has the puck. And beats Zuboff. Fans love it. Lead to Noonan. Across the line. Pass deflects off the skate. Cleared away by Diddick.
Vancouver just doing everything quicker than the Rangers. The Rangers need a power play, in my opinion, if they're to win this thing. They have had very little offense and even strength. The power play's got to do well.
Zuboff lost it. Here comes Bure. Bure shoots. Save by Richter in the mask.
Right on that helmet.
In the mask.
Oh, my.
Zuboff to Matteau. Matteau had it poke checked away, knocked away by Ditta. Cleared out by Babich. Bure almost found it again. Zuboff's got it. 40 seconds left in the Rangers' power play. Kovalov pass all the way across off the skate of Noonan. Matteau being wrestled by Ditta in front. Kevin Lowe is on. Dumps it ahead. Noonan's got the puck. Kovalov out of the corner. Back pass to Lowe. Across to Zuboff. Craven is there. Lowe turns. Takes the shot deflected by Bure. McLean poked it into the corner. Kovalov's got it. Holding 15 seconds in the power play. Zuboff to Matteau. Matteau to Lowe. Lowe shoots. Save. McLean. Rebound wide. Zubov missed the net, and it's cleared by Craven. That's it for the power play.
How many times have you seen Brian Leetch not able to go the full 2 minutes on the power play? He couldn't.
Lynch there to Kovalov. He gave it up. Back the other way, Jelena. On to Ronning. Ronning waits. Forced back by Lowe. Takes the shot. Saved by Richter. Mike Richter single-handedly keeping this game close for the Rangers.
It's amazing that he's able to keep functioning. He took a blast, a slap shot, right to the face mask, and he just shook it off and hung in there.
Shots are 19-9. We're 5 minutes into the second period. Canucks have picked up the hitting again. Lowe fires it into the crowd.
Rangers had one good scoring chance. One shot registered on the power play. The rebound was there, and Zubov missed the open side. Richter took a... He almost went down. He kept his balance and hung in there.
I'm trying to see if the cage was dented.
Oh, it possibly could. This is going to be a deflected... No, not. Straight up. Bang! Right off the side of the mask. He almost goes down. Look at him. He stumbles. He's backwards. However, he stays up on his feet. Amazing. Now, Zubov will have an open shot. You're going to see a big, juicy rebound. There it is. Bang. Zubov shot it high and wide.
15 minutes to go in the second. Canucks 1, Rangers nothing. Rangers 0 for 1 on the power play. Canucks 1 for 2. Mike Richter, 18 saves on 19 shots thus far. Ronning, Mamesso, and Jelena. Rangers control. McTavish, Koser, and Gilbert for the Rangers. Wells and Lidster. McTavish off the board to himself. Knocked away by Brown.
It's like the Rangers are trying to use more players than normal, Sam, realizing that they have to rest more between shifts.
Lead to Gilbert. Save McClain. Good shot by Greg Gilbert. Back the other way, Cliff Ronning. Ronning joined by Brown. Pass to Mamesso. Mamesso looks to the net. Pass blocked. Good play by Lidster. The net was knocked off, and the whistle stops play.
You'll see the shot from Pavel Bure once again. Oh, my. Right off the right side of his face mask. Do you see how he hung in there?
Back to the live action. Leetch is back on the ice. Moves it up the board. Shot by Brown. Goes wide. Around the boards. Glenn Anderson's got it. Anderson back on with Messier and Graves. Messier with a puck. Brown plays it out of the zone. Leetch played it back in. Brown. There's again. Courtnall. Beautiful play off his skate. Onto his stick. Courtnall looking toward the net. It's blocked by Bukaboom. Courtnall trying to play it ahead. Anderson blocked it. Forced it out of the zone. Courtnall tripped up by Graves. Pass off the board, stopped by Jeff Brown. Intercepted by Jeff Bukaboom. A little over 6 minutes gone by. Second period as Messier plays it to Anderson. Back to Messier. On to Graves, tipped it wide. Messier finds the puck. Out for Anderson. Taken away by Hennigan. Hennigan gets loose. On to Courtnall. Courtnall against Lowe. Courtnall waits for the trailer. It's Trevor Linden moving in on Glenn Anderson. Linden checked by Anderson into the boards. Nathan Lafayette against Sergei Zubov. Lafayette stays with it. Zubov lost his stick. He broke it. He had to drop it. Can't play with a broken stick. Zubov kicks it around to Graves. Graves can't clear. He does clear as he was hit by Linden.
Yeah, he took
able to get it out.
Took a solid hit to move the puck out of the zone.
Zubov went to the bench, the long route to get a new stick. Now he's back in the play. Larmer covered up for him against Bure. Zubov has the puck. Zubov for Kovalov. Kovalov on with Larmer. Larmer to the net. Kovalov waits. Pass for Larmer. He was taken down by Didek. Rebound comes out. Larmer finds it. Now it's Matteau against Didek. Didek takes down Matteau. Didek pushes the puck up the boards. Larmer gets there first. Larmer to Lowe. Lowe down the boards past Matteau. Past McClain. Larmer plays it. Back into the corner. It was blocked. Courtnall clears it out. 12:40 to go in the second. Kovalov has it back. Stripped up by... And a penalty call. Didek will go as he tripped up Kovalov. Rangers get another power play.
That's what the Rangers needed. Some good work from another line besides Messier. This time it was Larmer, Kovalov, and Matteau. Didek could have had about three penalties on this shift. Finally, he was called as Kovalov made a good move in the neutral zone, forcing Didek. Here's the move to the inside, and Didek sticks out his left leg, and the Rangers will have another power play. They only had one shot registered in the only other power play they've had in the game, as the Canucks showed some spectacular penalty killing. Again, this is a line the Rangers need to get going. Matteau and Didek. Look at Didek. One arm over Matteau, drags him down to the ice, pulls him down. Good efforts, but against the rules. Finally, Bill McCreary gives the New York Rangers their second power play. That evens out the power plays in the game now at two apiece.
Didick tripping, 7:27 the time. 1-0 Vancouver leading it with 12:33 to go, second period.
Not on the other power play. And let's watch him this time and see how long he can stay out.
Messier, Graves, and Noonan with Leach and Zuboff for the Rangers. Craven, Bure, Glenn, and Lume for Vancouver. Tipped ahead. Chant of defense up from the crowd. All the way down it goes. Zuboff moves it around to Brian Leach. On to Noonan. Noonan across the line, holds it, dropped to Messier. Messier around the boards for Leach. Messier with the puck, tipped in front, went wide off the stick of Noonan. Chases it down, leaves it for Zuboff. Zuboff, big shot, high off the glass. Graves has it, Bure is there, now Lume, pass to Messier, Graves goes to the net. Messier whacked by Glenn, Noonan in the corner with a puck. Pass back to Messier, tipped by Craven. Dumps it all the way down, 1 minute to go on the Rangers power play.
Oh, Messier set up Noonan, and Noonan had the open side, didn't finish.
Here is Leach across the line. Leach pass to Kovalov. Kovalov turns, holds. Kovalov on with Larmer and Matteau. Zuboff and Leach. Kovalov along the boards. Jeff Brown is there. Zuboff with Hunter. Kovalov's pass tipped, knocked down by Larmer. Larmer waits, trying to get a pass through to Matteau. It's blocked by Hennigan, who pokes it to the boards. Kovalov for Leach, who's in deep. Leach to Matteau. Back to Leach. Now to Kovalov. His shot blocked and hit his own man, Larmer. Kovalov's got the puck. Kovalov turns. Pass to Larmer. Give and go. Tipped by Brown, who was on the ice. Zuboff to Kovalov. Kovalov. Pass to Zuboff. He didn't see it. Leach has the puck. Deep to Larmer. 12 seconds in the power play. Leach with a shot. Wide. Bounces around to Kovalov. Kovalov. Checked by Nathan Lafayette. Rather by Jeff Brown. Gets it back for Matteau. Power play is over. Toward the net. Save McLean. Teams at full strength. Matteau to Kovalov. Another shot deflected across wide. Diddick goes for the puck and clears it. Zuboff has it back.
The Canucks still.
Here's Hunter stealing the puck and moving in. Drops it off for McIntyre. His shot sticked aside by Richter. Larmer's got it. He's without a helmet. Diddick was taken down. Rangers 3-on-2. Kortnoll catches up. Larmer in deep. Shot blocked by Glenn. Here's Lindstrom, and it went off a skate. Rangers can't get a shot through.
It went off of Matteau. They're hitting their own players. They're hitting the Canuck players. You know, they're working hard now. Can't get a break.
Pass out to Jeff Kortnoll off the boards for Lafayette. Richter plays it away from Lafayette. He's hit by Lindstrom. Wells swings it around, but it stopped. Good play by Glenn. Wells has it back. 9:40 to go in the second. 1-0. Here's a chance for Nemchinov. Moving in with Tikkanen. Nemchinov to Anderson. And he hit the post. He hit the crossbar. He had a wide open net. Here's Linden breaking back. Feed for Kortnoll. Off the board. His shot blocked by Nemchinov. Goes into the crowd.
Oh.
9:24 to go. Second.
Upstairs, the officials will review everything that they think is close. Did it hit the crossbar? Did the goalie stop it? Did it hit the bar underneath the crossbar? I don't know. What a shot. That may have been in. I'm not sure, but that was very strange looking again. I don't
know.
Tough
to tell.
The webbing did not move, but it may have hit the middle bar. And that looked like the crossbar when you saw that angle.
Yeah.
Of course, we had a flash of light at the time. It may have hit the crossbar. Tough to tell.
Yeah.
Black puck, black roof. Boy, the Rangers doing everything but can't finish. Oh, man, everything but finish. Moving the puck well. It's being reviewed upstairs right now. It's ruled no goal.
Yeah.
You know, one view that we didn't see is the direct overhead from up above. That may be more conclusive with the black puck and white ice down below. But you can see the Rangers are getting it going now. The power play didn't score. In fact, it didn't even register a shot, did it? I don't think. Yet it's getting lots of chances. It's now giving the team some offensive spurt. but they just can't get the puck through.
Two big chances. Zuboff missed the net on a rebound, and Anderson on the three-on-one hits the crossbar.
And how many times did the Rangers players hit their own players with shots?
Still, it remains 1-0 Vancouver with 9:24 to go, second period. Running Mamesso and Jelena. And the crowd going wild, waving towels, screaming at the top of their lungs. Brian Leetch has the puck. Drops it back for Messier. Jelena on him. Messier plays it to Bukubom. He waits and plays it across. All the way down it goes. This will be an icing. No, it's waved off.
It went through the crease. Right.
Hedekin's got it around to Jeff Brown. On off the stick of Jelena. Stopped by Leetch. Leetch still wins it. Finds Kovalov off the heel of his stick.
The Rangers are starting to do a lot better things right now, but they're not having any breaks, not getting any luck.
Messier to Graves. Backhander wide. Jelena and Leetch go for the puck. Leetch wins it. Leetch drops it off to Messier. On to Graves. Save McClain. Good chance there. Kovalov's got it. Stopped by Ronning. He has it back. Kovalov moving. Sets up Messier, but it went wide. Bukubom hit by Mamesso. Ronning tries to clear. Off the leg of Kovalov. Race for the puck. Richter beat Jelena to it. Clears it out of the zone.
The two-line pass now. A great play by Richter. He read. Brian Leetch was at the end of his shift and tired. Richter made a nice play.
Rangers close to beating Kirk McLean here.
See the puck coming across. You see the crossbar. It's exactly where it hits.
Yeah.
And out. A very good replay. A good look at it. Not much doubt. Hit the bottom portion of the crossbar and landed outside of the goal line. A good look at it. No goal. The Rangers have outshot Vancouver here in the second period, 5-4. And the Rangers in the last 5 or 6 minutes have been at their best.
8:28 to go in the second. No scoring here in the second. Power play goal by Jeff Brown in the first period. The only goal of the game. It came at 9:42.
Who knows what will happen, but remember the save Richter made off of Adams early in the second.
Graven for Adams. Adams into the corner against Zuboff. Lowe pokes it back in there. Zuboff against Adams. Kovalov looks for it. Swings it around to the other side. Didder comes in to play it. Takes the shot. Kicked away by Richter. Graven's pass intercepted by Kovalov, and he breaks out. Babich is back. Kovalov moves in with Larmer. Pass to Larmer. He tees it out for save by McClain. Larmer puts it in front, and McClain got a piece of that.
Now Rangers are starting to make things happen. Now it's Kirk McLean's turn to put on a show.
Matteau gets by Adams. Lead for Kovalov. Kovalov waits, and it went off his stick. Adams sends it out to Bure. Zuboff is back. Bure waits. Pass to Lume. Lume for Kortedal. He moves in, and he scores!
He says no goal. Bill McCreary says yes. It'll be reviewed. The entire puck has to be over the line. One goaltender made a spectacular save. That was McLean on Larmer. And then Mike Richter did his ultimate best. But did the puck go over the line? I think so. Not 100% sure, but I believe the puck went over the line. It has to go over the line completely. Let's see if you see white. I believe you will. Yes.
I believe it was
the
in,
puck
John.
Was over by 3 or 4 inches. No doubt. Mike Richter did everything possible to keep the puck out. Bill McCreary saw it over the line. He signaled goal. It's been reviewed upstairs. It's 2-0 Vancouver. And what a save by McLean on Steve Larmer just seconds prior to the Vancouver goal.
Jeff Kortedal, who had gone 13 games without a goal, got two in Game 5 in New York and scores one here tonight. It's 2-0 Vancouver with 7:20 to go in the second period. Kortedal from Lume and Bure at 12:29. Lume made a terrific play.
Oh, he sure did. The Rangers
offside,
went for it.
Whistled.
They went for it on the rush. They got what they wanted. That was a great scoring chance. And Kirk McLean robbed Steve Larmer. And then the Canucks went flying back the other way. Here's Kovalov. What a pass. What a save this is. You can see McLean was set waiting for the shot. Beautiful save. Seconds later, Vancouver went right on up the ice.
Larmer with goals in each of his last three games here in this series, in 4 of the 5 games. Almost had one there. Instead, down the other way, Vancouver, and it's a two-goal lead for the Canucks. 7 minutes to go in the second. Takeaway by Koser, looking for McTavish. He was checked by Lume, then knocked away by Glenn.
Antoski bumped by Koser. Has the puck. Gets it around to Lume. Gilbert is there. Off the boards, all the way down. The race is on. Will it be an icing? No, Richter's got to play it. Away from McIntyre. He's bumped by McIntyre. A penalty call. McIntyre, I believe, is going to get a penalty.
It's not a very smart play.
For bumping Richter.
Not a very smart play at all. His team has a 2-0 lead. He could have avoided Richter and should have. The rule reads you have to make an attempt to avoid the goaltender. McIntyre made no attempt, even though he had a Ranger up against him. So this penalty could be one that may hurt the hockey club. Look at McIntyre. He made no attempt to avoid Richter.
Right.
He had Lidstrom on him and still went into Richter. Look, he goes in behind Lidstrom, over to Richter, and bumps him. No attempt whatsoever to avoid the goaltender. So the Rangers, who still have time on their side, we've said that many times this season when they've trailed 2-0 in games. The puck in behind.
Rangers have had
the goaltender.
Sorry, John. Rangers have had three straight power plays here in the second period. They have failed to capitalize on the first two. It is 2-0 Vancouver. Rangers on the power play. Now 3-for-24 in this series.
One thing I like is Mike Keenan has put Kovalov with Messier. Kovalov's had a great second period. Kovalov has been better than Noonan with Messier, I think, now. And Keenan, I think, reads that. Now he's got them together to try and get something going. More pressure will be put on Vancouver's defense. They had no pressure on them in the first period, but lots here in the second period.
Craven, Bure, Brown, and Hedekin for Vancouver. That hit Gerard Gauthier, the linesman, on the left wrist. And he's trying to shake it off. Leach moving. Messier across. Messier shoots, deflected by Brown into the crowd. 6:22 to go, second period. Canucks leading 2-0. A minute 45 to go on the penalty to McIntyre. He went off for interference at 13:23.
Mark Messier has a saying in hockey, and that's let the puck do the work. And as he was flying up the ice, the great pass was made to him to allow him to dart into the offensive zone. He's a great skater. If you move the puck quickly, it's a nice combination.
Messier will take the faceoff against Murray Craven. Messier with Graves and Kovalov. He has scored points. Mark Messier has in 19 of 21 playoff games. Messier wins the faceoff. Kovalov looking for it. Messier's got it. Pass to Graves. Shot it wide. Bure knocked down and hit Kovalov in the helmet. Zubov. Kovalov's pass deflected across by Craven. Craven controls, clears the zone. Minute 25 to go on the power play. 6 minutes to go on the second. 2-0 Vancouver. Messier holding. Craven is there. Nice pass to Zubov. A bump by Bure. Slides it across. Leach in deep against Brown. Graves to Kovalov. Now Messier sets up Zubov. One times it wide. Rebound! Save McLean! He didn't know where it was. It hit him. Zubov to Messier. To Zubov. Bure is there. Long shot. Save McLean. Kovalov was tying up two men in front. Leach couldn't keep it in the zone. Leach starts the move. Pass across to Kovalov. He's got it. Slides it to Messier. Messier waiting. Back to Kovalov. He's looking. Pass. Score! Deflected in! It's a power play goal! The Rangers are on the board.
Finally, a break. And they should go crazy in New York. Oh, baby, what a play this is. The Rangers get themselves a break. They did everything. Kirk McLean was stopping the puck even when he didn't see it. And you wondered if the Rangers would ever have something good happen. And finally, the puck, as it's given to Kovalov from Messier, will be redirected off the skate blade of Murray Craven. Right through the legs of Kirk McLean with Adam Graves standing in front. Right through the legs of Graves and McLean. It's 2-1. The Rangers are alive. And you can even sense here in this building some concern. Vancouver's played a great game, but they only had the one goal lead now, and the Rangers are alive.
Dump. Alexei Kovalov gets the goal, and Mark Messier and Brian Leach get assists. Leach has points in 18 of 22 playoff games. Messier in 20 of 22 playoff games. They have been something. Ronning with the puck. It's a 2-1 game. Babich across off the stick of Ronning to Jelena. Jelena against Kevin Lowe. Lowe takes him out. They wrestle each other down. Fans roaring. Magellana grabbed Lowe by the head and pulled him down. Fans were upset there was no call. Rangers across. Larmer dropped past to Tikkanen. Plays it in deep. Larmer against Lume. Larmer walks off the stick check. Matteau in the corner against Ronning. Tikkanen against Lume. Matteau to the puck. Larmer's in front. Matteau around the net. Out to Bukaboom. Toward the net. Kicked away by McLean. Matteau with a hit on Ronning. Matteau takes it away from Lume. He's double-teamed by Lume and Ronning. Rangers with good puck possession here with a back pass by Tikkanen. Goes out of the zone and all the way back.
Well, Adam Graves does not get a point on the Rangers goal, but he was in front screening the goaltender. He got his job done.
This comes all the way down. Will be an icing on the Rangers. And play stops with 3:54 to go, second period. Each team with a goal. Kovalov from Messier and Leach at 14:42. Watch this.
Well, you got to pay a price. I mean, that's getting it done. That's getting the body between the other player and your goal net.
Vancouver fans were upset that there was no penalty on Kevin Lowe.
Remember the penalty that McIntyre took in the offensive zone as he bumped Mike Richter, did not avoid him. The Rangers capitalized with the power play and got themselves into the game.
Kovalov's goal is his ninth of the playoffs. Here's Graves across, takes the shot. It's blocked by Brown. His ninth of the playoffs and 20 points for Alexei Kovalov in his first Stanley Cup playoff season. Kovalov has the puck back. Messier is tied up with Trevor Linden. They're going stick to stick.
Mike Keenan is using Kovalov as much as he can, and so he should.
Off the stick of McLean, shot by Bukaboom, save off the shoulder of Kirk McLean. Bukaboom's got it, pass blocked by Hedekin. He took down Kovalov. And there's a whistle for an offside.
Kovalov made a good play. He was knocked down, yet he still reached out and snared the puck with his stick and pulled it back before Vancouver had the break. It was offside. Linden and Messier opposite one another. We haven't seen that much lately in the series. There they stay together. Linden doesn't have the puck, so he's got to make sure he keeps his opposite center, that's Messier, away from the puck. But the Rangers are now, for the first time in the game, and it's happened over the last 10 or 12 minutes, winning the battles for the loose pucks. They have started to control the game, yet they trail by one.
They have outshot Vancouver 11-6 here in the second period. Each team with a goal in the second. Rangers are 1-for-3 on the power play in the game. Vancouver 1-for-2. Zubov dumps it in. We're down to 3 minutes remaining in the second period. Vancouver leading 2-1, trying to even the Stanley Cup Finals. The Rangers trying to win it. Craven with the block, drop pass to Bure. Bure avoids Tikkanen, gets the puck back. Deflected, Rangers find it. Kevin Lowe. Pass Nemchinov. Babich got a piece of it. Nemchinov cuts in. He's tripped up, has the puck back in the corner. Babich has him. Nemchinov goes down, the puck up the boards. Adams to Bure. Back comes Zubov, he missed him. Bure against Lowe. Bure is in, saved by Richter. And it's cleared aside by Zubov. The net is off.
Spectacular play by Pavel Bure. You know, started back in the Vancouver zone where Babich outmuscled Nemchinov. Babich is so strong. So is Nemchinov. But Babich just got the puck up to Bure, the right winger, who came over to the left side of the ice. Grabbed the puck and man did he go. Nemchinov gets body control, has the puck. Now watch him get worked over by Babich. Look at Babich's strength. Now Bure will head to the puck now as he gets it from Adams. Look at him go. Watch him change gears. There he goes. Just plows to the outside, keeps his balance, and he forced Mike Richter into a very tough save on a tricky backhand. Pavel Bure, the Russian Rocket, with a great play.
The Rocket, who went to Philadelphia, took a helicopter ride for 3 hours to go to the hyperbaric chamber.
Oh, man. Well, it worked. He's flying. Yeah. And I'll tell you another thing, Sam. The first time he ever practiced with the Canucks as a kid, the first time, they had close to 3,000 people in the arena watching him with anticipation, and he's been everything they've expected.
And he's going to be paid for it, too.
A lot of fish and angles.
That's right. Bomesso slides it to Glenn. He's in for the shot wide. Bounces high in the air. Nobody saw it. Finally came down. Bukaboom batted it down. Swings it up the boards. Glenn keeps it in.
Now is this Vancouver's turn to change the momentum?
Lume kicks it ahead, but Leach stepped in. Nice pass to Messier. Off his stick, knocked away by Ronning. 1:50 to go. Second period. 2-1. Vancouver leading it. Bukaboom against Jelena. Past Leach. He was tripped up by Momesso. Graves with a quick pass to Anderson.
Momesso didn't even think about the puck. He wanted Graves. Or pardon me, he wanted Leach. He wanted Leach bad.
Up the boards. Jelena. He's hit by Gilbert. Ronning gets to the puck. Stopped by Lidster. McTavish takes it back. He's stopped by Hennigan. Off the boards. Cleared out by Ronning. Richter comes out to get it. 1:15 to go in the second period. Each team with a goal in the second. 2-1 Vancouver. McTavish was stopped by Brown. Back the other way, Greg Adams. Adams against Lidster. Save Richter with a blocker. Bounces down. Adams missed it. Anderson's got it. Off the boards to McTavish. He's got Gilbert wide, but Craven got a piece of it. Babich gives it away to Wells. Babich has the puck with 55 seconds to go in the period. Greg Adams. Pass, Craven trying to get it through to Bure. McTavish dumps in, got knocked down hard by Diddick. Babich has the puck, moves away from Gilbert. Diddick's pass blocked by Larmer. Long pass off the stick of Adams. Richter leaves it for Zubov. 30 seconds to go in the second period. Larmer at the red line lifts it ahead. Bounces to McLean, has trouble with it. Plays it across to Courtnall. Courtnall moves it to Brown, then got hit by Larmer and lost the stick. Courtnall's after Larmer. Lowell trying to stop Linden. Richter stops, waits for an opening, and decides to leave it for Kevin Lowell behind the net with 10 seconds.
Do you think he is Eddie Jackman out there or something? Well, the Rangers survived the first period. The Canucks survived the second period.
Lowell
and won. I think we're going to have one fabulous, absolutely spectacular third period.
Only once in this series has either team taken more than a one-goal lead into the third period. In Game 1, Rangers led 1-0 going into the third. Game 2, Rangers led 2-1 into the third. Game 3 was 3-1 Rangers into the third. Game 4 was 2-2. And Game 5, Vancouver led 1-0 into the third. Here we go. Messier, Graves, Kovalov, Bukovum, and Leach. McIntyre, Hunter, Antoski, Brown, and Hedekin for Vancouver. Leach up the middle. Brown sends it back.
Boy, it's interesting. Pat Quinn starts his big boys to try and get some hitting going, and the first hit was thrown by Antoski on Jeff Bukaboom. You see Kovalov again with Messier. Kovalov will be double shifted, I'm sure, here in the third period. He had four shots, as he said, in the second period.
Graves sends it in. Knowing Bill McCreary, unless something is really blatant, I don't think you're going to see penalties called here in the third. Drop pass. Antoski shot blocked off of Bukaboom. Messier checks Lafayette. Richter got a piece of it. Bukaboom moves it to Kovalov. All the way down. This will be an icing on the Rangers. Babich with a touch. We played 55 seconds in the third period. Alexei Kovalov, he really came alive in the second period. A lot of ice time for him.
He'll get double shifted when he's going well, and tonight he's going well. You see the ice time, first period, second period. Shifts doubled, ice time more than doubled. You know, he keeps that little troll for good luck above his stall. It was stolen after Game 7 of the New Jersey series, and then someone returned it in the mail, and it's back above his stall. And he had a little luck in the second period when his shot ricocheted in off of Murray Craven off his foot.
Richter stopped that one. Noonan out with the puck. Nemchinov with Tikkanen and Noonan. Noonan's long shot knocked aside by McLean. Tikkanen gets to the puck. Tikkanen to Noonan. Noonan pass across to Zubov. Zubov winds up and shoots wide. Nemchinov is battling in front with Diddick. Diddick has no stick. Shot by Noonan. Save McLean. Long rebound to Kevin Lowe. Zubov picked up by Courtnall toward the net. Tipped by Nemchinov. Nemchinov against Diddick, who's playing again without a stick. Tikkanen comes out in front. Can he get a shot off? It's blocked by Linden. Noonan shoots, and it hit the post. Linden can't clear. Nemchinov's got the puck. Diddick holds him. Back pass shot by Zubov wide.
Diddick's living on the edge, close to a penalty.
Rangers keep it in. Good play by Lowe. Around the boards. Nemchinov. Linden gave his stick up. Nemchinov for Noonan. He's hit by Lafayette. Passed by Tikkanen and blocked by Diddick, who got the stick from Linden. Babich with a check on Lowe. The puck alive. Linden without a stick. Gave it up. Nemchinov to Zubov with room. He fakes. He circles back. Zubov looks. Feeds Noonan. Noonan shoots wide. Around the boards. Here's Zubov. Zubov to Lowe. Linden is there without the stick. Tikkanen shoots. Deflected by Babich. Chopped up by Diddick off the stick of Noonan. Along the boards. Linden clears it out with a glove. And the Canucks survive. 2.5 minutes gone by in the third. Zubov to Larmer. Larmer to Kovalov. Kovalov against Brian Glenn. Saved by McClain through the screen.
Kovalov on the first shift with Messier. On the third shift, he's back on the ice. Mike Keenan knows that when Kovalov's going, play him. Play him a lot. He's a kid who loves to play. Trevor Linden gave up the stick to the defenseman, Didick. He had to do it, and you can see he's still exhausted from the long shift. He'll use the hand there. The Rangers keep the puck in, and he actually uses the hand again later. He tried to block the shot there of Zubov. It's good, smart playing by Linden without the stick. Smart. Now you'll see him, I think, go over to the boards in a moment and try and work the puck out.
There it comes.
Right here. Smart play by the Canucks captain.
Kovalov centering Matt Cohen, Larmer. Well, as Mike Keenan says, Alexei Kovalov is a thoroughbred, and you got to ride him. Here's Bure. He's a thoroughbred, moving with the puck. Pass behind Craven. Richter out to stop it for Bukaboom.
Kovalov denies.
Give it up to Craven. Sorry, John. Bure tied up with Matteau. Matteau bumped. Craven moves in. Leach stops him. Bure's got the puck. And gave it up to Kovalov. Kovalov past Larmer. Here's Lume. A little over 3 minutes gone by in the third period. 2-1 Vancouver leading it. Bukaboom pressed by Craven. Gets it to Kovalov off the boards. Larmer bumped by Hedekin. Able to clear the zone.
Vancouver defense pinching a little more as the series has moved along when the puck comes up the boards on the Rangers in the Rangers zone.
Hedekin moves in, slides it into the corner. Graves checked by Ronning. The Go Canucks Go chant goes up as Graves was able to lift it clear. Hedekin across to Jeff Brown. Graves, Messier, and Anderson on for the Rangers. Blocked by Zubov. That's an offside on Vancouver.
The Rangers during the Devils series seem to get their game, lose their game, and then get it back. Well, it's been the same in this series. They lost it for a good period of time, especially the last game and into the first period of this game. Then all of a sudden it's back. It's a very strange thing, but it's definitely back.
McTavish sends it in. He's on with Gilbert and Koser, Leach and Bukaboom. Thus far in the third period, Mike Keenan going with four defensemen. A little over 4 minutes gone by in the third. Around the boards, Gilbert gets to the puck. Gilbert turns, swings it in, past Ronning. McTavish behind the net, puts it in front, and it was blocked. A chance for Koser. Jelena gave it up to McTavish.
I think it was Momesso that pushed Koser, saving a goal. A great play defensively.
Koser had it knocked away by Hedekin. Momesso's got it, leaves it for Hedekin. Hedekin moves in on Bukaboom. Swings it around the board. Jelena stopped by Lowe, looking to play the puck. Kovalov finds it. Meets Linden. And gave it up to Momesso. Back comes Linden. Swings it around the boards. Instead, it goes up over the glass into the crowd. We played 4 minutes, 45 seconds of the third period.
McTavish made a nice play in behind Kirk McLean. Set the puck up for Joe Koser. And as he was about to shoot it, I believe Momesso pushes. And you'll see Koser in front right now. Boom, yes. Momesso, 27, pushed Koser. And I think Koser had an open net. McTavish with a nice play. Look at Koser in front. Now he'll slide to the top of the crease. And he's knocked off balance. A good defensive play by big Momesso.
Kovalov, Larmer, and Matteau on for the Rangers. Linden sends it in deep. Zubov back for it. Kortnall going for it. Zubov played it around, but Lafayette is there. His shot was blocked by Lowe. Matteau up the skate of Linden. Zubov has it. Devin Lowe. Rangers pull back. Lowe plays it to Zubov. Kortnall pressing. Zubov swings it back to Lowe. Lowe has no opening. It's knocked down. Good forecheck by Vancouver.
Yeah, Rangers, you know, you have to be confident in your faceoffs. You got to ice it.
Zubov pass. Kovalov didn't see it. Didick back for the puck. Around to Dave Babich. Out of the zone, past Zubov. Rangers have to go back to get it.
The only team I ever saw that never liked to ice the puck was the Red Army. And you could understand they were so good. Ice it if you're in trouble.
Nemchinov moving against Craven, slides it in. McLean plays it to the boards. Past Adams. Lidster is on with Wells for the first time here in the third period. McLean stops the puck for Lume. Lume blocked by Nemchinov. 6 minutes gone by in the third. 2-1, Vancouver leading it. Wells pinching in. It's knocked down by Glenn.
It's a pinch on Bure. Pat Quinn has Bure on the ice.
Adams against Lidster. Blocked by Lidster. Bounces down. Gloved on a short hop by Mike Richter and gets the whistle.
You know, if Mike Keenan hasn't used his 5 and 6 defensemen often. When they were on the ice, they had to face that guy. That's dangerous.
Rangers.
You know, the Rangers, when they came in for the first two games here in Vancouver, 3 of the Russian players forgot their passports. Dennis Ryan, the chief, was along for the ride and helped them out, got them into this country. He has really done a nice job with the Rangers and hockey in general, taking care of things like that.
Messier won the faceoff from Linden. Messier's on with Graves and Kovalov. Graves dumps in. McLean stops it for Hedekin. Hedekin moves it around the boards. Leach trying to get to it, missed it. Kept in by Kovalov. Jeff Brown swings it around. Linden goes for it. Pukaboom goes for him. Nice outlet pass. Quick pass intercepted as Courtnell was breaking down the left side. Leach stopped by Linden. Back the other way. The pass missed connection from Lafayette to Courtnell. Pukaboom back for it. Icing Vancouver. 13-17 to go in the third.
Vancouver so close to two great plays, and then they end up icing the puck. Mark Messier showing leadership in this game. Talk to him about leadership. He said he learned a lot of it from his father and a lot of it from Wayne Gretzky. He said Wayne Gretzky helped teach him how you compete every single game, every night at the office. Messier shows it in his face like the Rocket Richard did when he was a player in Montreal.
Mixed emotions for the Messier family. They couldn't be here tonight. They're down in Tampa for their opening game of the Roller Hockey League.
Yes, they're there watching. I'm sure they've got a television near them. And also, they're playing Montreal. That's a team that's owned by Yvonne Cornway, a former great player.
Kovalov stays on the ice, double shifting as he goes to center with Larmer and Matteau. Moved up the boards, goes into the crowd.
Kovalov's playing so much, you almost think he's being triple shifted. I saw him the other day at practice, sitting on his knees at the blue line, taking pucks and wristing them over top of the crossbar in behind to the glass. I mean, I don't know too many hockey players that can do that. The strength that he has in his hands and his wrists, it's really something. He's a kid who loves to play. The last guy off the ice all the time. And he's playing a lot right here, having fun, I'm sure.
Kovalov, Leach, and Larmer each have 4 goals to lead the Rangers in the Stanley Cup Finals in goals scored. Murray Craven sends in. Off the corner boards, Leach with Bure on him. Matteau pressed by Greg Adams. Bure goes for the puck. Bure waits, blocked by Kovalov. Kovalov is there, all 3 forwards were there. Kovalov moving in on Dinnick, who breaks it up with a nice poke check. Back the other way, Craven left it behind. Off the boards, Bure. Bure moves in, looks at Pukaboom. Bure, blocked by Pukaboom. Matteau can't clear. Bure in deep off the stick of Adams. Adams checked by Leach. Pukaboom has the puck. Open man is Larmer. 12:30 to go in the third. Larmer did not gain the red line. This will be an icing on the Rangers.
Bure ends up on the other side of the ice a lot. Again, a right winger. He's freelancing. He's like a rover. It's hard to find the rover sometimes. And he's been over on the opposite side of the ice trying to get free.
7 minutes, 36 seconds into the third. Vancouver's had only 1 shot on goal. Rangers have had 4. Canucks protecting a 2-1 lead. Ranger fans in attendance.
A lot of them.
Yes, sir. But Vancouver fans waving the white towels, urging their heroes on to try and urge them into a 7th game, which would be back in Madison Square Garden Tuesday night if the Canucks pull this one out to even the series. The Rangers want to end it right here. Richter out to get the puck. Around the board, Jelena for Vancouver. Near side, Gilbert takes it back behind the net. Up the boards and out of the zone.
Vancouver trying to make sure they don't over-forecheck, trying to protect their 1-goal lead. They don't want to sit back, but they won't send more than 1 guy deep.
Lomesso upended Gilbert. He's able to push it ahead. Anderson's pass blocked. Then he missed connection with Doug Lidster. Brown the other way. Hedekin, 11:35 to go in the third. Back pass, run and shoot, saved by Richter. And he holds on, gets the whistle. 11:32 to go in the third. Sergio Lomesso.
He was
for the bench.
He was tripped up by Jay Wells, forced offside. Watch how he comes back. Wells pulls him offside. Watch him swim. Get himself back onside. A terrific effort. They're going crazy. I mean, they are going crazy here in Vancouver. Now Momesso's down to stay onside and sets up this shot by Ronning. And Richter with a save.
Linden and Momesso. Linden goes to the puck and Leach got a piece of it. Leach moves it but gave it up to Jake Brown for the long shot. It scores! A giveaway, a turnover in the Ranger zone results in a Vancouver goal. It's 3-1.
See the faceoff. The Rangers get the puck. That's what they want. But they don't handle it well, and there's the shot with traffic. That's the second shot by Brown that has gone in the game, and Mike Richter has yet to see it.
Jeff Brown has come alive in this series with three goals, two in this game. Kovalov back for the Rangers, dropped to Graves. He shoots, save McClain. Rebound missed by Graves. Linden's got the puck. 11-10 to go in the third. Stopped by Leach at the line. He shoots, save McClain. Linden to the puck. Gets it ahead for Lafayette. Kept in by Leach. Pass off the skate of Kovalov. Babich pulled down by Kovalov, who got away with that one. Kovalov has it knocked away by Didek. Messier's got the puck. Didek has him. Kovalov looking for it. Kortnov clears the zone. 10:45 to go in the third. Canucks have regained the two-goal lead, their second two-goal lead of the game. Leach for Kovalov. Plays it across. Brown, unassisted. At 8:35, Brown's sixth goal of the playoffs, his third of this series. Good rush by Jurki Lume. Lume against Zubov. Lume checked by Zubov. Noonan moves the puck. Nemchinov's got it. He's checked by Adams. Zubov moving. Trying to lead Tikkanen, but missed. McLean's got to play it back into the corner. Off the stick of Noonan. Shot by Nemchinov. Save McLean. Clears the rebound aside. Adams to Bure. Low is back. Bure moves in. Bure backhander. Glove save by Richter. Oh, what a save he made. Bure with an electrifying rush. And Richter with a great save. Best.
Pavel Bure, backhand shot this time. Mike Richter, splendid with the save. Bure had 16 goals in 22 games going into this one, and he was robbed.
The Stanley Cup record is 19. Across the line, Gilbert, he's bumped by Hedekin, gets it back. Ronning picks him up, slid it all the way through. In deep is Jay Wells. Ronning tries to move it. Wells stopped it. Hedekin takes it back. 9:30 to go in the third. 3-1. Vancouver leading it. Richter looks around. Place it into the corner. Ronning is there. Koser checking Momesso. Lidster is without a stick. Now he's got it back. Lafayette plays it to Ronning. Hops past him. Ronning and Lidster go for it. Momesso is there. Back to Ronning. The We Want the Cup chant has gone up from the Canucks fans here at the Pacific Coliseum. Richter stops the puck for Kevin Lowe. Under 9 minutes to go in the third. Zubov has it for Larmer. Vancouver leading 3-1. Didek drives it around the boards. And it's cleared out. The Canucks, who did it in the first round of the playoffs when they were down 3-1, coming back against Calgary, are trying to come back to even this series against the Rangers. Zubov with 8:25 to go.
And look at now, Vancouver sending no one deep. They've got the two-goal lead. They won't get trapped.
Almost.
Look at this.
Cordell didn't see it. It would have been a two-on-one with Bure.
But still, they're not sending anybody deep. You see how they've changed their game plan? They know they've got the two-goal lead. Why take chances?
Kortnov chopped that by Kovalov. Bangs with Zubov. Kovalov dumps it out. Graves finds it on to Anderson. Anderson against Hedekin. Couldn't put it in front. Hedekin blocked it. Anderson wrestles with Hedekin. Graves taken down by Brown. Hedekin fires out. Bukovum chases. It'll be an icing. 7:49 to go in the third. Vancouver with the only goal here in the third, leading 3-1.
7:49. Mike Keenan looks up, calculates the time. Now has to calculate who he wants on the ice and how much he wants him out there. Take another look at the Pavel Bure save. He's gone to the backhand a lot in this game. He's got a long reach. And there you see Mike Richter with a splendid, splendid save. See, Bure can play the left side, cut across to the right side because he has such a great backhand shot.
Messier with Graves and Anderson. Rangers control. Leach toward the net. Gloved by McClain. Drops it off the whistle and stops
play.
There's
a good, real good job by the two defensemen. Messier and Graves tried to drive to the net. And Hedigan grabbed one player, which was Messier. Brown grabbed Graves and drove him to the side of the net. Look at both sides of the goalposts. Look at the Rangers trying to get there. They can't. And that makes it very easy for Kirk McClain to hang on to the puck.
7:44 to go as Messier will take the draw with Craven. Rangers 27 shots, Canucks 28. But the Canucks lead 3-1. Two goals in the first, one here in the third. Messier wins, Leach fakes on Bure. Pass to Anderson, he turns, tried to pass it through to Graves, but he was tied up. Shot went wide by Vukaboom. Leach has the puck. Down the boards, Anderson trying to tip it in front. Cleared aside by Brown. Anderson to the puck. Messier had it knocked away by Brown. Adams and Vukaboom go for it. Knocked away by Hedigan. Anderson tries to keep it in. Blocked by Craven.
But you'll see Ranger defense start to pinch more now and take chances. It may be up to Richter to get the two-on-ones against him to try and take care of that.
Brown,
the Rangers need to go for it here a little bit.
And the 1940 chant comes up from the Canucks fans. Aimed at the Rangers. 7 minutes to go in the third. Messier for Tikkanen. Taking it after the puck. Hit by Babich. Ronning swings it around the boards. Wells waits for it. It was intercepted by Jelena. Lidster taps it back to Messier. He was still in the zone. Offside is whistled. 6:45 to go. Third period. Only one time in the last 22 years has a Stanley Cup final gone to seven games. That was in 1987. It was Mike Keenan's Flyers and the Edmonton Oilers.
And win the Stanley Cup. I think it was 2-1. Anyway, Glenn Anderson scored the key goal late through the legs of Ron Hextall as Philadelphia had a gallant comeback attempt.
McClain moves the puck. Mamesso can't clear. Blocked by Wells. Ronning does clear. 6.5 minutes to go. 3-1 Vancouver. Tikkanen. He's tied up by Jelena. What a play by Jelena in the neutral zone. Lidster has the puck. Gets it to Wells. Fans were upset. Jelena was knocked down. He goes limping to the bench. Lidster moves in on Brian Glynn. Glynn takes him out. Tikkanen can't find the puck. Jurke Lume does. Up the boards. It bounces down. Lowe can't keep it in the zone. Courtnell breaks by. Courtnell moves in. Richter comes out. Knocks it away. But the net is empty. Craven shoots wide. Richter trying to get back. He does. Bure knocked away by Nemchino.
It's a courageous play by Mike Richter, and it worked.
Lidster drops it back to Kevin Lowe. 5:40 to go in the third. 3-1 Vancouver. Gilbert sends it in. McClain trying to clear. Knocked down by Greg Gilbert. Koser trying to center. Comes back to Gilbert. He shoots. Save McClain. The rebound is cleared aside by Bure. Kept in by Zubov. Zubov plays it in deep for Gilbert. Oh, he went high into the face of Jeff Brown and then got tripped up by Brown, and nothing is called by Bill McCreary. Zuboff has the puck. Rangers changing. McTavish, who was knocked down by Linden. Linden has the puck. 5 minutes to go in the third. Matteau. Bure breaks by Leach. And he was fell down as Leach had grabbed him a little bit and upended him. Zuboff with a pass. Matteau trying to beat Didick. Hip checked him. Larmer toward the net. Kovalov was tied up with Courtnall. Zuboff to Kovalov. Matteau's in front. Pass for Matteau. He's tied up by Didick. Can't get a shot off. His stick was being tied up. Linden hit by Matteau. Bure lifts the puck. And it's out of the zone with 4.5 minutes to go. Kovalov up the middle for Matteau. He breaks in. He's hooked by Hedekin. As I mentioned earlier, McCreary will not make a call. He will let them play. It goes all the way down. Icing on Vancouver.
Mike Richter's done his part in this game. Cordner would have had a partial breakaway. Mike Richter took the puck and Cordner. That's a great play. And then Kevin Lowe covered up, as you see in front. Mike Richter has been terrific. He has done his part after game five. There's 4:14 to go. When will he be called over to the bench?
Canucks have had only four shots on goal, but Richter was beaten, screened on a shot that Jeff Brown took after a Rangers turnover.
Yet the Canucks have not given up much defensively in the third period.
Messier, Graves and Anderson. Messier against Linden. Messier wins. Leach shoots just wide. Around the boards, bookable. Back behind the net, Messier. Checked by Brian Glenn. Graves against Lume. Lume takes out Graves. Messier's got the puck. Back pass to Leach. Leach against Lafayette. Toward the net, but wide. Bookable moves in deep against Glenn. Glenn gets the elbow into Bookable. Puck up the boards. Linden able to clear the zone. Leach plays it across. Nobody there. Lume gets to it. Lume moves in and shoots high and wide. 3:40 to go. Messier with the puck. Linden forechecking. Leach hit by Cortnall. Able to clear the zone. Anderson had it knocked away by Linden. That's an offside. 3:29 to go.
There was 8:36 to go in the third period. The Rangers had had 26 shots on goal. There's now 3:29 to go. The Rangers have had 27 shots. So they've only had one. The Rangers have put pressure on. The Canucks have been in their own zone, but they haven't folded. They have played smart defensive hockey. And Mike Keenan's team is trying somehow to get something. Now he comes out with his fourth line. One thing about them is they're certainly fresh.
McTavish with Toser and Gilbert, Lidster and Wells. 3:25 to go. 3-1, Vancouver leading it. Sent in by Koser. McLean leaves it. Swung around the boards by Brown. Wells can't stop it. It's going to be ruled an icing. This is a surprise. I thought Wells could have played the puck, but it went past him, and it's an icing. That's a break for the Rangers.
I think it must have flipped over a stick or something. He did try to play it. Then he got tied up with the linesman. It was also interesting, the last faceoff was in the neutral zone. Momesso took the draw, not Ronning. Now, does Ronning have a problem? There's the puck. He tried to stop it, but it went in the air past him and past the linesman, so it is icing. Ronning now comes off. He didn't take the last faceoff. You wonder if he has an arm injury or something. Craven now on the ice as the Canucks changed.
Craven with Adams and Bure. Hedekin and Brown. Canucks control. Hedekin has the puck. For Adams, pinching his Lidster. Good check on Adams. Digging it loose. Koser didn't see it. Craven tries to move it. Blocked by Noonan. Adams gets it out of the zone. Chance for Bure. Bure breaks in on Wells. Wells blocked it with his left skate. Good play by Jay Wells. 2:50 to go. Rangers down by two. Long shot. Just trickled wide on the net. McLean had trouble with it. Koser is checked. A bump on Craven. He's got knocked down by Gilbert. Brown moved the puck. Adams after it. He missed it. Koser shoots, blocked in front by Craven. Out comes Hedekin. 2-on-1 with Bure. Wells is back. Hedekin. Saved by Richter. Saved by Richter on Bure, and the Rangers clear.
Two best skaters. 20
to go.
Two best skaters for Vancouver had the 2-on-1. Hedekin and Bure. And Mike Richter did it again. An icing call against the Rangers.
2:18 to go. Time running out on the Rangers. The Canucks are 2:18 away from making this a seven-game series.
There's the shot by Noonan. Kirk McLean. Was that close? Now you see the Rangers. Four dark jerseys will move in deep. Right here. The right defenseman pinches. That's Lidster, I believe. Now you see Vancouver. 2-on-1, Hedekin and Bure, the two best skaters. And it's a great play defensively as Bure was taken out of the play.
Zubov has the puck with 2:10 to go. Forechecking is Zelina. Here's Kevin Lowe. Lowe carries in.
drops it to Kovalov. Shot off the glove of McLean. Zuboff winds up his shot, deflected in front, cleared aside by Didek. Lowe has it, plays it deep. Kovalov fires off the stick of running into the chest of McLean. It bounces down, a whistle stops play.
And Matteau bumped into Kirk McLean. McLean thought about doing something, and then he caught his emotions. He now talks things over with the referee, and Babich comes over to talk to the goaltender to calm him down. High shot into the chest. Look at Matteau. Slash, and then a little bump, and McLean right there thought about going over and then turned around to appeal to the referee, and he kept his emotions in check as he is 1 minute 53 seconds away from another five-hour plane flight to New York for Game 7.
The Vancouver Canucks have faced elimination five times, this being number five. That's a good shot by Larmer, stopped by McLean. They have won the first four. They're trying to make it five in a row in elimination games. Bukaboom to the puck. 1:40 to go. Didek for Lafayette. Puts it in front to Cordell. He scores! The play continues. The Canucks think it was in. The red light went on. They're skating down the other way. I thought that puck was in.
It did, Sam, but the referee's not sure. And they have to wait for a stoppage before it can be reviewed.
Wow.
And if it's a goal, the time will come back on the clock. And I think it was a goal.
I do, too. Anderson lost it. Bure shoots and went wide.
This time will be played over again.
Here's Leach. 1:05 to go. It's still 3-1 right now. Canucks thought they had a goal that looked like they should have. Pass in front. That shot scored by Messier. Will it count? It might be waved off.
Oh, we're going to have one of the all-time interesting calls here. The play has already been reviewed. The timekeeper already knows whether Vancouver has a goal, and I think they do. And all that time after the play will be reviewed, or will be put back on the clock if it is a goal. The Rangers bench is not going crazy, Sam. I think they realize that Courtnell's shot was in.
It is being reviewed. This is the 19th review of the playoffs this year. Brian Lewis in the booth standing up to your right. Was this in? Let's see.
Watch the middle bar. Yes.
Oh, I think that's in.
It's underneath.
Yeah.
Underneath the crossbar. You'll see it here. Yeah. That caught the middle bar and the bar on top of the net, and the puck ringed around and out. It ringed around the top of the net and out. The Rangers' goal will be taken away. Vancouver will have the 4-1 lead, and the time of the Courtnell goal will be put back on the clock.
The number four goes up on the board. They're going crazy at Pacific. And this, my friends, is going to go to the ultimate game in hockey. The seventh game of the Stanley Cup Finals. The Canucks are going to win this one. And Tuesday night will be the ultimate game.
That'll be like 2 days of listening to people scratch their nails on chalkboards. It'll be unbearable.
That was Mrs. Griffiths, the owner, the widow of the late Frank Griffith, who died in April. They are going absolutely wild in Vancouver. The Canucks have done it. They have come from two games down to tie this series.
They are saluting their players. This will be the last 1 minute 32 seconds of the season in Vancouver. Only one game left.
Courtnell does it again. Four goals in two games for Jeff Courtnell. His second of the game and ninth of the playoffs from Lafayette and Didek at 18:28. There's a minute 32 left in the game. It's 4-1 Vancouver. They have won this third period with two goals and great defensive play. And they have won this game with a great defensive effort. 1:15 to go.
On a positive note, Sam, for the Canucks, it's all positive, of course, of what they've done.
Oh, a giveaway. Lafayette to Linden. It went off his stick. And it's cleared out. Go ahead, John.
For the Rangers, they found their game again. It had been missing in action for quite a significant period of time. And that's something they can build on. I also think 2 days off will help the Rangers. Vancouver probably wants to play the game tomorrow.
Yeah.
But not the Rangers. They can reacquire everything. Linden, by the way, was just injured and knocked down again by Messier.
Low to the puck. Adams on him. 30 seconds to go in the game. Messier holding. Craven after him. Lidster's got the puck. Larmer. McLean stops it. It's interesting that you point out the positive, but still the result of 4-1 doesn't look all that good, John.
Oh, I understand that, but they were not outplayed. In fact, they played pretty well after the first period.
And that's it. The Vancouver Canucks have defeated the Rangers. This series is going to 7.